Hey there, this is René for Network Lessons. In this video, I'd like to explain a bit about chassis aggregation. So what we have here is a Cisco 6500 switch. And you can see that it has some different modules and cards. So for example, these over here, these are line cards. And these line cards, for example, in this picture, we have Ethernet interfaces, but you have different line cards with different interfaces. These over here, those are the supervisors. And the supervisor, that's where you have your CPU, memory, flash memory, and so on. That's basically the brains of the chassis. And we also have some power supplies over here. So we've got two power supplies with redundant power feeds. Okay, so this single chassis has quite some redundancy. The dual supervisors, dual power supplies, multiple line cards. But if you want even more redundancy, then you can add a second chassis. So let me give you an example. So let's say that this is one chassis with a line card, second line card, supervisor, a second supervisor, and it has two power supplies. So for redundancy reasons, we are going to add a second switch like this. There we go. Now what I'm going to do is I will connect these two switches to each other. And I will use two cables using two different line cards. And what I can do is I can form an ether channel with these two links that I have. So without switch aggregation, this is how it is connected. Now, let's say that this is the core layer, these two switches. And now I'm going to add a distribution layer. So I got the distribution layer switch, number one, and number two. Now let's connect these to the core layer. So from distribution switch one, one cable to the first chassis and the second cable to the other one. And the same thing for distribution layer switch two, like this. So right now we have a redundant network. We got redundant links and so on. One disadvantage of this setup right now is that if you use layer 2 and VLANs, then spanning tree will block a couple of links. So probably it will block something like this, this link, and this link to have a loop-free topology. Now what I can do to prevent this is aggregate the two core switches. So what we can do with the way it is set up right now, is we can aggregate the two core switches into a single logical or virtual switch. And this is similar to stacking, stack-wise. But the main difference is that you can do this with two switches, and you can use the regular Ethernet interfaces and the Ether channel in between those two core switches. So what it will look like then is something like this. So we got a single core switch. So the distribution layer switches, they think they're connected to a single switch. And what I can do now, since the distribution layer switches think they're connected to a single switch, I can use Ether channel in between the distribution layer and the core layer. So I can create one Ether channel over here and the second one over there. So this is pretty cool because we now have an ether channel to two different physical switches, which is one virtual switch. And we call this MEC, multi-chassis ether channel. So that's pretty cool. Now, what I can do to take this one step further is I can do some switch virtualization on the distribution layer. So, for example, let me get rid of all of this. So we got an aggregated core switch over here. Now, if I would also use stacking on the distribution layer, then those switches also become one single virtual switch. And what you can do then is add some links in between and then create one big ether channel. So in reality, we have a couple of physical switches, but the logical picture is that we only have two virtual switches. So then you can form one ether channel, and spanning tree will no longer block any ports in your network. So that's one of the reasons why we use chassis aggregation. Now, if you want to see this in action, I have another lesson, which is about VSS, virtual switching system. And there I used two 6500 switches to configure this using VSS, virtual switching system. Now, I hope this video has been useful. Thanks for watching, and until next time.